I mentioned earlier that it's a multiple writer protocol, which means that this action that's going on can be happening simultaneously for the same page X on different nodes of the cluster. That's perfectly fine so far as the protocol is concerned, because the assumption is that the user has an association between locks and the data structure is governed by that lock. So even if the same page is being modified, hopefully different portions of the same page is being modified, because concurrently, if a page is being modified, that means that different locks are protecting the portions of the page that are being modified by the different processes. Now, if writes are happening to the same portion of a page under different locks, that's the user's problem. That's a data race. That's not the problem of the DSM software. It's an application problem, because it represents a data race that should not have been there if the application was constructed correctly. But if the application is constructed correctly and multiple data structures are hosted in the same page and the data structures are all governed by different locks, DSM software has a way of ensuring that changes made to a critical section under a particular lock is propagated from one processor to the next processor, where the first processor is the current owner of the lock and the next processor is the next user of the lock. So this implementation that I've detailed here is an example of the cooperation between the distributed shared memory software and the operating system to make it all happen. And in particular, Treadmarks implemented this LRC multiple writer coherence protocol on a Unix system. And in the Unix system, the operating system generates an exception called sigsegv in the operating system layer when a shared page is accessed by a thread. This exception is caught by the Treadmarks runtime handler. And at that point, the DSM software gets into gear, contacts the owner of the page, checks the status of the page, and if the page is invalid, then it gets the page and the diffs for that page. And once it brings in the contents of the page and the diffs, it creates a current version of the page. And if the process that is trying to access the page is making a read access, then there is no problem. But if the process that wants to use that page wants to write to it, at that point it creates a twin and does all the things that I just mentioned. So one thing that you will notice is that there is space overhead for the creation of the twin at the point of a write. You have to create a twin. And then at the point of a release, you of course can get rid of the twin, but you're creating a diff data structure. So the twin and the diffs are all data structures of the implementation of distributed shared memory. And as time goes by, there could be a lot of these diffs that are lying around in different nodes. Imagine that a page was touched by 10 different processors. In that case, there are going to be diffs lying around in 10 different processors, and if 11th processor wants to access that same page, the DSM software has to go and bring the diffs from these 10 prior users of the page, get the original page from the owner, apply the diffs to create the new page. A lot of latency is involved before the guy who needs the page now can start using it. And also, there is a lot of space overhead in the fact that all these diffs are lying around. So one of the things that happens in the DSM software is garbage collection. And that is, you keep a watermark of what is the amount of diffs that have been created in the entire system. If it exceeds a threshold, then you start applying these diffs to the original copy of the page at the owner so that you can then get rid of the diffs completely. Why do you need that? Well, the diffs are going to be lying around till a long time, till the next time the page is accessed by someone. You don't want that. So what you're trying to do is you're reducing the space overhead in the DSM implementation by periodically doing this garbage collection and applying the diffs to the original copy of the page so that you can get rid of it from the system. You don't want to do it too eagerly, but you don't want to wait too long also, because if a page has not been accessed for a long time, diffs are going to be lying around for a long time. So there'll be a daemon process in every node that every once in a while wakes up and sees how much diffs have been created in my node. If it exceeds the threshold, then it says, okay, time to get to work. Let me go and apply these diffs to the original copy of the page so that I can get rid of the diffs.